In this episode, I will work on this BMW e60. On this car, I will replace the front seats. And on this car, it's not the first time that I will replace these seats. If you want to see the first time, I will leave a link down in the video description. But now the new seats are with memories and lumbar support. And you can see the seats are not fully electrical, are semi-electrical. And the new seats, they are with memories, fully electrical and with lumbar support. First step is to remove the seats. And to remove the seat belt from the seat, this have a T50. I need to remove the front screws, they are with T50. And from the back the same, I need to remove these two screws, the same, they are with T50. And the last step is to remove the plug. Okay, and now I can remove the seat from the car. And I will repeat the process with the seat. First thing, I will remove the seat belt. Like so. And the last step, I need to unplug the wiring. Next step is to remove the glove box compartment, because I have to make some changes in the wiring. Now I need to add some pins in these plugs because the wiring is different. This wiring is from the donor car with the electric seats, with fully electric seats with memories. And this one have this plug, and they are a little bit different. Last time when I have been here, I have retrofitted electric heated seats on this car. So last time I have already pulled the wiring for the CAN communication, these two ones. But I think I will need power supply. At the end of this video, I will explain you the difference between these wirings. Okay, for the moment, I need to remove some panels from here. Perfect. Okay, so from this plug, I need to add these two pins here, like so, and this one. Okay, and now here in this plug, this is the power supply for the module that will control the new seat. This is the power supply. It's this big plug, plus this one is the ground. One is the ground. And on this side, I have the CAN communication wiring. And I have these two wires for that. Perfect. And the last one, it's a ground. And these are all the wirings. Okay, so for the new seats to work in this car, they will need power supply. The right seat will need a supplementary ground in this plug and CAN communication. The wires for CAN communication I have already mounted on the car from the last time. On this plug, I will need the ground. I have already have it. I will need the power supply and the limbas. The power supply, limbas and ground for this plug are for the switches from the seat, and CAN communication and power supply are for the module from the seat, because the switches are communicating in limbas to these wires, and the module is connected and communicating in the CAN network. Okay, so I will need to pull two wires from this plug, the power supply and limbas for the module. And I will need to do the same from that seat, from the driver's seat. And the wires, I will connect them here underneath the dashboard behind the glove box. Okay, now this ground from here, this will need to go and be connected here. This old ground, I will remove it from the car because it's not needed anymore. This was for the heated seat in the old configuration. Okay, I will use this wire to pull the new wires. Perfect. And the rest of the wiring will remain in the same position because they are for the airbag system. Okay, this side is done. Now I will pull the wiring from the other side here, and after that I will finish the connection for the both seats. On this side the same, I need to remove the speaker grill. Okay, now I will transfer the pins for the power supply. This one is the ground. It's this one. And this one is the power supply. There's this one from here. Perfect. And now these wires, they will be used for CAN communication, and this plug is done. These two wires will be removed, and now from this one . Okay, now I need to remove all these ornaments from here, these covers, to pull these two wires on the other side. Perfect. Now the wiring on the driver's side, it's done, it's ready. I will start to mount back everything here. Now I need to remove this panel, the rear seat, this panel, to pull a wire from the front to the trunk. Okay, now I need to connect everything, and to be able to do that, first I need to pull all the wires in the correct place. Perfect. Now in this plug, this is the plug from the switch module, switch center module. I need to open the plug. Next, in pin 2, I will need to add this wire, like so. And now, this pin, this one, this wire, with this one, and this one need to be connected together. Good, perfect. Next step are these wires, the same. I will need to connect them together with this one from here. Smoking! And last step, these two wires are for the CAN communication. And we need to be connected with these two ones from here. And the CAN wires are also connected. perfect. Now if everything is connected, I will mount this back. Now I will start to mount back the seats, but first I will clean a little bit this area. And now the driver part. It's heavy. Perfect. Next step, I will start to mount back everything. But first I will make a test. Okay, to test this seat I need to connect back the buttons. It's working. Perfect. Perfetto. Okay, now let's test the driver side. The same, switch on the ignition. Connect the module. Hey, it's working. Perfect. Yeah, it's working. By the way, have you seen the difference between this and this? This is for the passenger. I will put this type of buttons here because they are more beautiful, and I will show you in a minute how I will do this. Now you can see here, this is the driver side switch, this is the passenger. You see the difference, and you can see here the difference, here the switches and here, because this one was not with memory on the driver side because these seats are from a car with the right steering, and I have need to take out the switches from this one. I need to make some holes for the switches in this case, because this case have this hole and this one didn't have it, and so on. And this type of switches are from a BMW F01 7 series. And I have a set of this type of switches from one car that was flooded, and the electronic side is destroyed, but the switches are perfect for me now. So first I need to disassemble this unit. This have T9 screws. You can see here the end of the world. This thing will pop out. Now the control unit and the switches. To remove this switch, I need to close these tabs. You see these tabs? I need to close them. Like so. Now the switch, you see this part from here, slide up. And removed. Next, this one, the same. This only need to be pushed. And it's out. I need this to switch covers. And one screw is missing. No, it's not missing. It's somewhere around here. Now I remove the cover. I remove this contactor. Now I can remove the board. This one is a little bit different. Have only two clips. I need to close the clips and push them down. One ugly button out. And the second ugly button out. Oops. Next step is to mount back this. Mount back the new switches. Seems to be okay. I will not connect this plug. I have a plug here, but I will not connect it because I don't know what is the status of this switch. Oops, I don't like this. This one is moving perfect, but I don't like this. Okay. They are a little bit different. And for this switch to be happy, I will apply some grease. Everything is back in place. Beautiful. Me like it. Okay. Now put back the cover. Beautiful, nice. This is big difference between day and night. This type are very ugly. Okay.
Oops. Oopsik. Oopsie boopsie.
Now the seats are mounted, everything is cleaned. Next step is to coat this car to add these options, because for example this seat, the memory, won't work. On the other one it's working. Because this seat is not coated, for example, this have all the functions that are working, but the memory function is not working. So after coating this will work. After scanning this car, I have a ton of errors, but most of the errors, all of the errors are caused by me because I have removed the seats from the car. So my next step is to clear all the errors. Switch off the ignition. Switch on the ignition. And the only errors that have remained are about communication, lack of communication between the seat heating modules and the KGM. KGM is the body getaway module. This error are caused because the car is coated with the old type of seats, and now these seats have a different type of control unit, and because of that I have these errors. But after coating, the errors will disappear. So if I will go to vehicle information, vehicle equipment, you can see here I have seat heating for driver and front passenger, and the sport seat for driver and passenger. Now I will need to add front electric seats with memories and lumbar support. Now I will start to coat this car. I will exit from here. I will open NCS Expert. I will choose a file, road profile, expert man. Okay. I will choose an body or chassis E60 from CIS. Okay. Next I will enter an FA E60. I will check the box for calculate checksum. Okay. Now from here, first thing, I want to delete 481 that are for sport seats. 481. 481, delete. It's gone. Now I will need to add 459. That's the sign from the dollar, 459. I will hit add, 459, okay. And the lumbar support, it's 488. The same as the sign from the dollar, 488. 488, add. Okay, and seat heating, 494, it's already there, 494, okay. After that, I will hit okay. I will hit back, process ACU. I will go to CIS first, okay, change job, FA right, okay, execute job. Job active, job ended. Now I will change the ACU and I will go to LMA, the light module, because on BMW's cars, the FA, it's righted in the CIS and the light module. The same, change job, FA right, okay, execute job, job active, job ended. Now, after changing the FA on the car, this doesn't mean that the car is coded. I have changed only the list. Now, to code the module with this option, I will go change ACU. First thing, I will select KGM, the getaway module. Okay, change job, SG code run, and execute job. Now the NCS will code this module with the new settings. Code ended, perfect. Then change ACU, and I have here BFS. This is one of the seats. Change job, SG code run, execute job, coding active, coding ended, change ACU, and FAS is the other seat, the same, change job, SG code run, execute job, coding active, coding ended. Perfect. Now I will go back, I will disconnect from this car, I will reconnect to this car, set up connection. After scanning the car on the KGM, we have the same, the two errors, because I didn't erase them. I will go on the KGM, component triggering, delete fault memory, trigger component, identification, ACU test, okay, close, and it's green, no more error. Now, if we'll go to vehicle equipment, we need to find here lumbar support for driver and front passenger, seat heating from driver and front passenger, seat adjustment electric with memory. And after coding with the ignition switched on, the memory function, it's working. Perfect. And everything is perfect, everything is working on this car. Before I will go and I will end this video, I want to explain you a little bit about the system, because I don't want you to flood the comment section down below with a ton of questions. So, if your car didn't have fully electrical seats with memory or without memory, but they are fully electrical, there are a big difference. For you to be able to retrofit that seats on your car, you will need to pull four wires to every seat on the car. Two wires are the twisted wires, they are for CAN communication. One wire is limb bus for the switches from the seat, and another wire is for powering the switches. Of course, the switches will need ground, but you already have ground at the plug on the seat, and you can make a splice there and power your switch module. The difference between the full electrical ones and the half electrical ones are in the control unit. The full electrical one have a control unit that will control the electric motor. The half electrical ones have switches that are directly controlling the electrical motor. It will be something like if you push the switch to move the seat forward, two wires will be applied to the battery and will move the seat. If you reverse the wire, the seat will go in the opposite direction. This is the way that this system is working. But on the full electrical ones with memory, the control unit will control the electric motors and the switches will not be connected directly to the control unit, will be connected to the switch center module. On the old generation BMW e60, the non-LCA model, the switch center console is the module that will have the switches for heating seat, parking distance control, and so on. That is the switch center control. On the LCA module, the switch center control is this small unit that is mounted behind the glove box. So the switches from the seats are connected via limb bus to this module, and this module will translate that communication into CAN communication and will give the signal back to the seat. The power supply that will control the switches from the seats is the same with the power supply that is used for this module. The fuse for this power supply is in the trunk, and from the trunk you'll have three wires, one for every seat and one for this module. So you can connect the wires from the switches from the seats directly to this module, because in the rear fuse box there is one fuse for all these modules. For CAN communication is the same, you need to pull wires from every seat to one splice of CAN communication. And the same, you can find that CAN communication directly at this module. I hope you learned something new in this video, I hope you understand what I have told you and what you have seen. Be careful, this is not a do-it-yourself video, you do it on your own risk. use your common sense and don't cut corners. And this is all for this video, but I'm not done with this car. I need to retrofit on this car an electric steering column adjustment. So stay tuned for the next video with this jump.